intellectual products. What about the businessman? You've talked about capitalism. I'd like to know his role in this.
Well, the businessman also is as recent a product as the intellectual. Before the birth of capitalism, there were no professional businessmen, and there were no professional intellectuals. Both the mind and material production and trade were enslaved and ruled by the various combinations of Attilas and witch doctors, which means by a powerful government, by an absolutist type of government, whether it was the feudal absolutism or the absolute monarchies of Europe of the past Renaissance period. In any case, the producers of material goods, the traders, and the producers of ideas, the teachers, philosophers, the early scientists, were men without official status, without a profession, and at the total mercy of the political rulers, which means at the mercy of rule by force. It is only since the Industrial Revolution, the birth of a pre-society, the society of capitalism, that there was a new class of men, which is the free producers of material goods, the businessmen, the industrialists. They, of course, are the producers in the strict sense of the word, or should be. But they are the greatest victims of today's society. They are the ones who have been betrayed by modern intellectuals. And in this sense, both businessmen and intellectuals will commit suicide by destroying each other, and the fault belongs to the intellectuals. The businessman is the man who has to use his mind to deal with reality, to study facts, to produce material goods. He is the man who serves as the transmission belt of the discoveries of science and carries the products of science to all levels of society. He is the one who takes the invention of a theoretical scientist or of an inventor, transforms them into useful products, and putting them into mass production makes them available to all levels of society. The businessman is the man who has achieved the enormous, historically miraculous rise in the standard of living of mankind during the 19th century. He is the one who has lived up to the role of a producer, to the role of a rational, creative man. But the intellectuals have never given him credit for it, have regarded him as if he were an Attila, and being afraid of freedom themselves, have been looking from the start of the Industrial Revolution for some form of an Attila to protect them, the intellectuals, against the free market of ideas.